Thank you. Oh, the interviews.
Well, hello everyone. What an amazing, amazing turnout. Thank you so much for coming out tonight on this such a miserable evening as well. And we'll make sure we try and get you home for the match. Anyway, welcome to you all to St. Martin's Christmas Carol Concert. Again, thank you for joining us today, and it's great to see so many of you. This evening, we hope to bring you a fabulous festive time. So forget all that's going on outside. And what we want you to do is come and sing out loud with us to some of your favourite Christmas carols. Our marvellous choir, they're here to sprinkle their music magic. And we have some very special guests too, in the shape of the Backworth Colliery Brass Band. Along the way there'll be stories, poems and more to remind us just what Christmas is really all about. Now you can follow everything in our handy little booklet that you've all got. It has all the carol words in it, so there's no excuse for you to get up on your feet and belt them out, which is what we want, of course, if you're able to. And then sit back and enjoy the choir and the brass band who will entertain you and give you a bit of a rest. There's some amazing raffle prizes and tickets will be available at the interval, along with refreshments, so enjoy those. And David tells me that there are some gluten-free refreshments with no nuts. So thank you again for your company. We hope you all have a super enjoyable time. And now I'm going to hand over to Jim, who's going to tell us a story to get things started.
The Christmas story. The story of Christmas began over 2,000 years ago with a visit. This was not an ordinary visit, because the visitor was an angel. The angel called Gabriel was sent from God to a city in Galilee called Nazareth, where a lady called Mary lived, to speak to her. The angel said to Mary, "You are highly favored. The Lord is with you, and you are blessed among women." Now Mary was a bit troubled about all this and wondered why the angel was saying these things to her. But Gabriel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary, for you have found favour with God. You shall bear a son and call him Jesus, and he shall be great. And he shall be called the Son of the Highest, and God shall give him the throne of his father David." Yet Mary was still confused, saying that she had not been with a man, so how could this be? So the angel said to her that the Holy Ghost and the power of God would take charge, and she would bear a son, to be called the Son of God. The angel then assured Mary that nothing is impossible with God, and to prove it, her cousin Elizabeth, who was not young and was really too old to have a baby, would also bear a son. Mary decided to visit Elizabeth to see about this, and she stayed with her for about 3 months before returning to her own home. As for Elizabeth, when her time came, she did give birth to a son. And although there was a bit of a debate about should he be called after his father, Zacharias, he eventually settled on the name of John. So what the angel Gabriel said to Mary about Elizabeth came true. And now the other part of what Gabriel promised Mary will take place. So if you were able, would you please stand for this carol?
Oh,
You like the story?
56.
Thank you.
lights are twinkling, snow's on the ground. The children fast asleep, there's not a murmur, nor a sound. It's quiet behind the presents under the Christmas tree. My gaze begins to wander to our nativity, to prayer and surprise their child who was born in the midst of a stable on a Christmas morning. A humble beginning for one so small, a boy that was born to take care of us all. A star shining bright in the sky as he lay, for the magi with presents as he lay in the cave. Old frankincense and myrrh were gifts they did bring, for a child born so humble, destined to be king. So as you wake up on a cold Christmas morn, remember the child in the cave that was born, to share peace and love, and to save us from sin. Just open your heart and let Jesus in.
We sing O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Thank you. Awesome. Thank you very much.
Yeah, it's not watching for the end.
father is to ride along on open sleigh.
Hey!
Jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Dashing through the snow, for the one who's open
sleigh.
Joy, be the ginger.
Like
no, because it's not. It's actually important.
gets me nerves. I've never two or three more.
Now I'm going to get the ball.
is the Christ.
Can I just say, having looked at the opposition, I can only assume there's been some severe skullduggery.
Thanks for
that. Thank you, Joe.
I'd just like to say thank you to everybody who took part. It's been a great laugh. Some cookies have never been baked before in my life. You can tell by the taste. And then we had a good laugh doing it, so I hope you've all enjoyed it. So I'd just like to start the second talk if you want to get your seats ready.
Just like to say before we start off the second half, and you've all been generous with your raffle ticket buying, and it's just to let you know that the raffle will be drawn on Sunday the 18th at the service here, and we'll ensure that the winner gets the prize. We promise you're under God's roof here, so that's a promise. So that's Sunday the 18th, the raffle will be drawn then. So thank you again for that. Also, if you can keep your hat, keep your candles ready, Kath's going to light all your candles as well.
Just
wait for this song. Whilst you sing this song.
Thank you.
Because the angel had some really good news of great joy, which would make them very happy. The angel gave them the news that there was a child born, a saviour, which is Christ the Lord, and this is a sign to them, and that they will find the baby lying in a manger, wrapped in swaddling clothes. As soon as the angels had returned to heaven, the shepherds had a chat with each other and decided that they should go to Bethlehem and see what the angel has just told them. They hurried to the stable to find Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. And when they heard the explanation of how the baby came to be born, they were overjoyed, and they left and spread the good news far and wide.
Joy to the world and peace to all men. The season of goodwill, alleluia, amen. People preparing for joyous acclaim. Kindness and generosity given their name. Bells ring out from every city and town, reminding everyone who wears the crown. The King of all kings and Messiah for all. Carols are sung as we deck the hall. Mistletoe is hung in the hope of a kiss, bringing strangers together in Christmas bliss. Snow falling from the sky, a winter wonderland, reaching out for snowflakes landing in our hand. Santa is the receptacle of hope and joy to every expectant girl and boy, bringing them gifts and smile to their face. Mary the mother, so full of grace. A fairy is adorned on every decorated tree. Christ is born and visited by three. Shepherds and kings followed the star, carrying a message and gifts from afar. A global event recognised each year, a time for celebration and of good cheer. Families together raising a glass, congregations meeting for midnight mass. School plays arranged, parents will attend. Religious message to children will send. Little donkey sung by adolescent choir, with sheets and tea towels their handmade attire. Jumpers and scarves, winter apparels. Groups will gather to Christmas carols. Malt wine and mince pies, the traditional currency. 5 gold rings and a partridge in a pear tree. Eyes light up when Christmas is here. It's everyone's favourite time of the year, when neighbours, friends and family will gather round the Christmas tree to share a drink and a festive song, hoping good times will soon come along, where wars are no more and humanity will share. Every nation joins together in harmony and prayer.
With the red ribbon. No one knows for certain
when the word Christingle was first used. Christingle consists of an orange representing the world and a lighted candle to represent Christ, the light of the world. Nuts and fruits and sweets on the cocktail sticks around the candle represent God's bounty and goodness in providing fruits of the earth. Red ribbon around the middle reminds us the blood of Christ, shed for all people on the cross at Calvary. Christingle reminding us that God so loved the world that he gave us his only Son, that in darkness for the world there shines a great light.
When Jesus was born, there were three wise men, also called the Magi, who had travelled from the east, asking, "Where is he, the born King of the Jews? For we've seen a star in the east and have come to worship him." Now a ruler called King Herod heard about the Magi, met them, and asked them all about the baby and where he was born. So they told him that they thought it was in Bethlehem. Herod also said that he wanted to know about the star and what time it appeared. And he told them to go to Bethlehem and find the child, seeing that he also wanted to worship him. The Magi then left Herod, and amazingly the star, which they first saw in the east, led them all the way till it came to the place where the baby was and remained above it. When they went into the stable, the Magi saw the baby with Mary, but were overcome with joy, and they all knelt down to worship him. They then presented the baby with their precious gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh before leaving. The Magi then had a dream telling them not to tell Herod anything about the baby, so they went back to their own country by another route to avoid it. Joseph also had a dream where the angel told him to take Mary and the baby into Egypt for safety, as Herod, who was furious with the Magi for ignoring his orders, intended to kill all the young children in Bethlehem. So they went to Egypt and stayed there for some time. Jesus grew up to be an intelligent young man, wanting to learn everything about life and wanting to improve the lives of people, but tragically losing his life for his beliefs. Unlike most stories, our story has no end of it, as after over 2,000 years, Jesus still lives in the life of millions of people throughout the world.
I want to give you a brief history of carols and how the singing of them came about and why we sing carols. It wouldn't be Christmas without the singing of them. They have the power to summon up a special kind of midwinter magic for us, like the aroma of warm mince pies, the twinkling lights on the Christmas trees, the smell of cinnamon, and a mental picture of a baby in a manger. And it also signals the countdown for Christmas Day for children and adults all over the world. It is such a magical time. Carols have been sung all over the world and can be traced back to the 14th century. But back then, they were Christian pagan songs. They were sung only around villages, in processions, or sung by travelling minstrels. They were at that time never sung in a church, but they eventually became a big part of the church's celebrations. That was until the year 1640, when they were banned by the Puritans, and then later on, even the Victorians didn't sing them very much. Carols told a story, and they were sung during all the four seasons. There were May carols and harvest carols, and in special times of the church's year. But only the tradition of singing them at Christmas has survived. The word carol means a dance or song of praise and joy. And one of the oldest surviving carols is "While Shepherds Watch Their Flocks by Night." This one has a 16th century tune and a 17th century words. There are carols we sing that are old and new. Some are solemn and some are fun and childlike. Some carols have even reached number one in the charts and earned their singers millions of pounds, though some of those are really Christmas songs. The nation's favourite carol for the last 6 years has been O Holy Night. I wonder what your favourite carol is. We learned these carols as children, and yet they are among the few songs that we remember the words to all our lives. And still today, the tradition of singing carols around the villages, the streets and towns, in the shopping centres, lots of other places, still happens as the story of Jesus' birth is told, just like it was all those years ago. So when we sing the lovely carols, whether it be in a church, in our schools, in our towns, our shopping centres, with our children, or in our homes, we all remember that special story of Christ's birth.
Once in Royal David's Cathedral.
Thank you.
Well, I hope you've enjoyed that as our evening draws near. We've certainly enjoyed performing with you. I hope you all also are feeling now in the Christmas spirit. So I'm sure you all are. That was brilliant. I'd just like to say a few thanks before we finish to everyone who's participated in our little concert today. Firstly, to Jim for his words and narration of the first Christmas. Thank you, Jim. To Kath and to Andrew for their wonderful original poems. I'm sure you agree they were wonderful. Doris, thank you, Doris, for the entertaining Chris Tingle story. Very thank you. And Carol's brief history of Carol. And thanks to Lorna for judging the Christmas cookie competition. Thank you for only picking your mums for second place. And to everyone who's helped with the half-plane refreshments, the cookie competition and the raffle, amazingly donated prizes, they're fantastic. Thank you for that. So thanks so much to everyone who helped, but because you've just blown us away with your numbers here. So, and please thank you again for everybody who did the refreshments and managed to feed and give you a drink there. Thank you for that. And Sandra and everyone else. So thank you. To Linda, thank you. And Harrison's, this wonderful booklet that you've got there. Linda organised the printing and Harrison's printed it for us. So please take them away with you. It's been a wonderful event and they've been great. So thanks to Linda and Harrison for that. A huge big thank you to Andrew, our musical director. St. Martin's Choir. There's so much to our little church. They're amazing. Now I've got a special thank you to the members of the Backworth Colliery Brass Band. You guys have added so much to our concert this evening, so thank you. Thanks to Nikita for persuading you to come over. I'd also like to mention, because someone's asked me to mention, there is a carol service at St. Anthony's on next Sunday, the Sunday of the 11th. I don't have the exact time, but I'm sure you'll be able to it's either 2 or 3, but you'll be able to find out, I'm sure. And that's at St. Anthony, so if anyone can go down there and support that church, everyone there would certainly appreciate it. So, thanks again for everybody coming. We much appreciate it. And just before we sing our final tune, I'd just like to say this little prayer. We thank God for the joyful fun of the Christmas season. Thank you for this time where we can celebrate Christmas together and make merry memories with our friends. Deliver us from evil by the blessing which Christ brings and teach us to be merry with clear hearts. May the Christmas morning make us happy to be thy children and Christmas evening bring us to our beds with grateful thoughts, forgiving and forgiven. For Jesus' sake. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you. Lord.